Ooh, yeah. Look at that. Boom. What's up, people? So today, somebody did something amazing and donated some tools to Genius Garage. I don't even know what they are yet, but they're in boxes, and we're gonna open them up together because it's very exciting that somebody cared. They actually found out about Genius Garage from the Petrolicious video on my Dodge Viper, because Genius Garage was mentioned in there. And I think that's just amazing and touching that people out there in the community care in car world. So we're gonna open those up. It's gonna be a lot of fun. But today I wanted to talk to all you guys and the one or two girls that are actually fans on this channel about tools. And no, I'm not referring to myself. Thank you, trolls. I'm actually referring to tools and why they're important, okay? So as you all probably have figured out by now, I have built crazy things my entire life, and I can't do that just with my fingers. You gotta have some tools, but is there like some magic land or a particular brand or somewhere to get tools, and how do you do that? And it's just important. I don't know if you guys ever seen the movie Gran Torino, but the Clint Eastwood character, he took the kid shopping for tools. I think he even let him borrow some or took him and he can pay him back later and whatnot. And it really requires somebody, and oftentimes somebody older, a mentor, caring about young people to say, hey, you need to get some tools. You got to start somewhere. It's going to take a long time to build them up. You're not going to just end up being like a master mechanic or craftsman overnight, but where do you start? So I want to tell you about my experience with tools in Genius Garage before we open them up. So this darn old box and everything are my personal tools. This old steel wrinkle finished black toolbox. I kind of like the old school being out of steel. I guess it could have been something else, but it sort of connects me with a bunch of old guys I looked up to when I was a kid when I got it. But I bought this in college, and let me just get it down. It's heavy. Okay, I'll put it here because that's brilliant, right? I bought this when I was in college. I was saving up some money, and instead of just putting it all in the car parts when I had a Porsche 944, I got some tools. And it was also meaningful because my grandpa went with me to a Sears to buy them. So I started off with a toolbox, and I had just enough money for that. And then, and this thing is so beat up over the years because in building Genius Garage, I let the students for a number of years just use my personal tools. So you can imagine what my personal tools are like nowadays before we got the bigger one and a donation to do that. But basically up in the top, you gotta have important things. I got safety wire, pliers, and this is a total mess from what it used to be, so don't judge me. Or judge me if you want, I don't care. I got messy because I let, young people use it. You gotta have your proper pliers and everything like that. In the top, you gotta have good screwdrivers. Don't cheap out on screwdrivers, okay? Find ones that are pretty decent. And I've had these same screwdrivers since way back when I was in college. But you need a good enough assortment. You don't need to go crazy. You're probably gonna have a couple of little ones like these, They're flathead and Phillips. You're gonna have some that are fairly precise, but longer. It's important to have something long so you can be all precise with it like this or get into hard to reach places. And you need three or four sizes of flatheads. These bigger ones have a hexagonal shape here in case you need to put a wrench on it and turn it, but realize that's you're getting in the territory of breaking stuff. I got some teeny tiny screwdrivers. I don't even know where they came from. I had them forever in case you gotta work on something small, some electronics or something like that. So screwdrivers in the top drawer, pinchy or cutty things up here. What, you wanna judge me because I don't wanna use a technical term? I don't care. Anyway, in here, wrenches. So how I looked at it, this is so messy. I am sorry, guys. Anyway, I do like these ratcheting open-end wrenches. My metric ones have a flexible side here, okay? And they ratchet in one direction. Those worked really great on cars that use metric, like European stuff, Japanese stuff, and newer American stuff, because it's tight, you gotta get in there. And these have suited me really well, primarily, okay? Some of them are broken, my 10 millimeter's broken, my half inch is broken, I should probably replace those, I'll get to it someday, probably. And then my American standard size ones, they're non-flexible, but they've got a little bit of a turn. Now these, I didn't see it being as necessary to have the ones that flex, because usually things that are American standard are kind of big and clunky and you got more room to work with, and they're a little tougher. The ones that flex sort of wear out over time. Also, these are really great tools. This is a Nipex, made designed in Germany. So it's like a really amazing channel lock slash, I can't think of the non-PC. So crescent wrench, yeah, that's what it is. I only know the non-PC ways to call it. But anyway, so This is works as a really precise, really awesome crescent wrench, and it's really also awesome because you can squeeze things like that. So a neat tool to have. And then down here, I had Allen wrenches and things like my tire gauge, which God only knows where that is now. So basically, you got to start off somewhere. Getting a smaller toolbox like this, maybe three drawers and one that's going to last you a lifetime, you know, something strong, steel, whatnot, is a really good choice for you young people. You've got to start somewhere. So this is what I had. And this is the only toolbox I had, actually, when I got that Ferrari mechanic job in college, my senior year in college, no joke. And they knew I only had these own tools, but you have to start somewhere. And they saw my talent, and I got to start here. So remember, guys, you don't just have to start off huge to be able to have quality things. And if I ever get some free time, I'm going to go through all my tools, because that was like the saddest thing I've ever seen. Nothing's where it should be, and it's all a mess. Because... well, anyway, we'll get to that. But when Genius Garage got a donation to get their own tools, these big tools stayed back here in like the race and fabrication room. And then when I started the aerospace and design program, they didn't have their own tools. So again, my tools had to go to the aerospace room. So anyway, so I got it out for this. So this toolbox, this big red one with all the stickers. Now, don't just throw any old stickers on your toolbox, guys. Let them mean something over time. All these stickers mean something to me, and I'll get to that if you want. But, you know, generally up here are the smarter tools. You got things like soldering iron, nicer scissors, you know, little high pressure air gauge. You know, you've got the mechanic stethoscope. You'll get into little taps and dies, or like clever little tools like this, you know. Things you don't use that often but are precise. You know, of course, you're going to have your caliper and micrometers and such and whatnot. Keep those things. I like them up in the top, or if I'm balancing Weber carburetors or SU carburetors, doing old timey stuff. You come down, you start getting into ratchets and whatnot. Oh, God, this looks terrible. I have got to organize this. That's what happens with Genius Garage. It's the real world. What do you want from me? Plus, I'm not sponsored, so, you know, doing the best I can with what I got, time-wise. Sockets and whatnot. You get into bigger stuff. I usually put things like hammers and mallets and files, things down in the bottom because they're heavier. You want to balance your toolbox. And you know, might have a pickle fork for busting loose a ball joint in a car. Stuff like that, pry bars. Down at the bottom, I've got some power tools. You know, you got an angle grinder. I've got my old power drill, which kind of has a story. I bought this years ago when I was restoring a Lotus 11 Le Mans and had to do about a bajillion rivets. And I know I said bajillion totally wrong, but I'm old and I make up words. What do you want? So I bought this. It's an old Milwaukee drill that you plug into the wall. I didn't want to mess with batteries at that time because I figured they'd go dead by the time I drilled enough rivets. But this drill has been used for everything, forever, and heavy duty stuff. I think I've even started small motors with it, and it's still kicking butt. So, you know, it's not pretty anymore, but it still works like a champ. And that's a lesson for all you young people out there that want to work on stuff. Get quality that lasts. You know, it's going to grow with you. It's going to mean something. It's kind of like my Viper in the Petrolicious video. Great car. It gets to age with me. It's a compliment to life. That's what good tools are. Don't cheap out on junk tools like made in foreign countries where like the metallurgy sucks and they're cheap to buy. They're not going to last. You're not going to be able to do a quality job. Just remember that. You know, when I get down here, you got saws and everything like that. But these are my old tools and they are just so sad right now. But I'll organize them and then go through it, clean them all up, re-lubricate everything, and it'll be fine. Now that the Genius Garage students are gone for a little bit of time. But the stickers, you know, I just used to put stickers on here from tracks I used to go to. You know, Indy, there's Watkins Glen, Road America, you know, NASA, we used to visit them with the students. Oh, an old pinup girl. Oh, get over yourself. It's from the 50s, and she's wearing swim clothes. Pittsburgh. It's just, you know, old stickers I had, left over. Chaparral, Duesenberg, neat stuff. So it means something. So, you know, you guys will collect stickers like that over time, and it's pretty cool. And when I get some more time, I'll go through my sad old tools and clean them all up. But every dent, every scratch just has a story and talks about the past and where that's going. And that's what led to me being able to create Genius Garage for other young people. We have a lot of young people out there getting six-figure jobs at places from everywhere from General Motors to Tesla to Honda. So, you know, think about it that way. Quality tools, a lot of hard work with your hands, a lot of dreams, a lot of blood, sweat, and tears that goes into that makes the world even better in the future. So here's the Genius Garage tools. And we had to buy them. None of these tool companies sponsored us. So if I say anything about brands at this time, you know it's honest because we don't get anything from anybody. Get it? Okay. That's why magazines stink, because it's all sponsored content, you know what I mean? And Ed Bullion once said, like, you get a magazine, you figure out who all their sponsors are, you forget about all the things they talk positively about, the things relating to their sponsors, and if they talk positively about anything that's not sponsoring it, then you know it's legit. So, bought this big toolbox, similar sort of mindset. You just have to have everything you need to basically do what you're doing. You know, at Genius Garage, we don't have any big tools. We don't have, you know, big bandsaws and drill presses and lathes and mills and stuff, because they wouldn't be used terribly often. And or we don't necessarily have the resources for it. But I'm saying this because if you guys know all the crazy builds I've done in the past before Genius Garage, I did it all with this and like one MIG welder. So that should be a lesson to you all that if you invest in good tools and the ones that you need, it's all about how smart you are to create amazing things. It's not just about, oh, well, I have $50,000 in tool. I'm better than you. No, who has money for that? It's all about how good you are. But make sure you buy quality stuff. So how about we get past me telling silly stories and open up these boxes? I don't know what's in them. I legit don't know what's in them. So a guy emails me after the Petrolicious video, and he was really moved by Genius Garage, which I appreciate. Thank you. And he had some extra tools and wanted to send them. So I'm really hoping this isn't a bomb. I don't know this person and I don't know what's in it, because that would really suck. But it might make good YouTube if I blow up. And then we'll call it the Casey Foundation. Maybe that'll make Genius Garage go. I'll have to blow up in a fire explosion from like a terrorist before anybody cares. Okay, hooray, it's like Christmas, but for somebody else, because I never had Christmas. But that's a whole nother story. Okay, what do we got? All right. Well, first of all, it's Milwaukee, which actually is cool. I have generally found their stuff to be really good quality. What we got here? Ooh, it's a 3/8 impact wrench. That is handy. All right. So impact wrenches, I don't use them tons, because usually precise stuff with racing, you don't, but they're very helpful if you got a good mechanic that knows what they're doing. So this is a 3/8 drive, and this is gonna be super helpful, because the one impact wrench that we have is 1/2 inch. It's actually also a Milwaukee, believe it or not. And that is a big hoss, but this will be great for some smaller stuff where you don't want to get out the big guns. But you know, you need to get the job done or not use all your manpower. So awesome, thank you. I think some students are going to love this. What else do we got? Yes. Wait, tell me what this is. All right, so it's red lithium, lithium ion battery. It's only red because the box. Is it an impact gun? Why don't you tell me what this is? Give me your secrets. Looks like an impact gun. Is it a quick drive one? Okay, let's find out. It's so new and fancy. I'm old, basically old. I don't know anything about new and fancy things. Actually, sometimes I do, but mostly my students teach me about new and fancy things, or, you know, lingo or the internet. Whoa. All right. Okay, cool. So this is a quick drive sort of a thing. Like, you know, it's not a typical, you put a drill in it, but you put something in with a hexagonal. This is gonna be a great tool. Be fantastic for getting things done. And I think the biggest moral of the story is here, I am beside myself honored that somebody cared enough about Genius Garage to send us some amazing tools for the students. How cool is that? What else we got? All right. I think this is also another one of these. So fantastic, we got two. That means one can go to aerospace and one can go to the racing side. That's spectacular. Although I'm gonna have to be careful about students using power tools when building an airplane, because airplanes are much more delicate and require precise, delicate touch oftentimes. Okay, what else do we got? It's very exciting. Maybe it'd be helpful I didn't lose my Swiss Army knife. Doot, 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 doot. Where'd it go? See, this is how I lose all my Swiss Army knives. I had a black one that was really nice. I thought that would be good because I'm kind of a dirt ball and my Swiss Army knife, as you can see, is so beat up that everything's off of it and the toothpick and everything are gone and I like chipped the knife and such. So anyway, oh, we're also not sponsored by Victorinox. So you know, if I talk nicely about it, I'm either a MacGyver fan and freak or I really like them. And I actually am a MacGyver freak. Okay, so I bent my audio equipment too. Hooray, we'll just set this here. Do you guys like the amount of honesty in this video? I hope you do, because I'm not trying to perform or do some perfect production. This is the real world. The nice thing, see, honesty in life and opinions, well, we all know what they say about opinions, but It's difficult in this world to be able to afford to be honest. Think about it. The nature of politics and social settings, the nature of a camera, the nature of anybody can watch this video, and I'm actually being honest. People hate honesty and they want to crush you for it, but I don't care. So I'm going to be honest. Yes, hand tools. What up? Those look great. And they're even the Genius Garage colors. Okay, what do we got here? Ha 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 ha. Here are all the bits for those great electronic tools we got. Look at that. They got the hexagonal parts down here. So whether they're screwdrivers or drill bits or something, it's a quick lock sort of thing. So it's going to really move things along and speed it up. And, you know, in life and in Genius Garage, it's not about just doing it faster. It's about the students learning. But if you got good tools and you can do your job more efficiently, then you're going to be able to get more work done. And that goes for saying whether you're learning or you're a career mechanic. Got some really nice open-end wrenches here. The Milwaukee's. We've got American Standard. Awesome. Very, very helpful. Got another charger. Ooh, spectacular. This is the kind of charger we actually already have. So no more uncharged batteries. Spectacular. Hey, we got a tape measure, which means we can either erase them. No, this will be really great. Fantastic. Couple more batteries. What's up? That's very helpful. Okay, so maybe I have to get another toolbox and everything for the aerospace team. This is gonna be great. What do we got here? Oh, wow. We've got a whole socket set. 3/8-inch drive, got a flexible head, extension, got a spark plug wrench. That's awesome. What up? We have got, looks like a drill, faster drilling speed. It gives you the name like fuel. I don't know why they call it fuel, it's electric. See that? Total honesty. Milwaukee would probably get mad at me if I said that, why did you name your electric tool fuel? Because we have more fuel? Because now we're not burning? We're using electricity? I don't know. Ooh, this thing looks legit. Okay, so it's got the nice ratcheting down drill head. I like that. Don't you hate those old shut keys like back in the old day? Yeah, this is nice. Okay, heavy. Feels like I could like throw it and I wouldn't break it. Very helpful. Very helpful. And it's got that, which will clamp on here. Let's see. I think you maybe just turn it. Yes, this is spectacular. Absolutely spectacular. I gotta be honest, you guys. You know, I've worked for years to do Genius Garage. And the formula works. Look at this. Isn't this cool? You know, the Genius Garage formula works. But I'm stuck here in the cornfields of Ohio, and I've got young people that want to come here from literally all around the world. I mean, like, every continent but Antarctica, including Ivy League schools. But nobody around here gets it, because nothing new happens in the Midwest. And the other problem is I'm not from the right socioeconomic class to just call up my CEO buddy X to actually support this and make it a big deal. So I've got something that can attract all the brightest young minds from literally around the world and give them everything they can't get in education to get them ready for industry. And here we are. But let's not focus on the negative. That's a hugely positive thing to make industry and a nation stronger and find the brightest young people from all around the world. So I'm just gonna focus on the positive right now and say how touched I am that somebody cares enough to donate tools to my students. Thank you. So we've got some really nice things here. Real precise, precision screwdriver set. We got Phillips, we got flathead. Are these both flathead? Yeah, two tiny flatheads. Those are gonna be very helpful. Probably when one of the students accidentally breaks something electronic and we've got to fix it. What else have we got here? These are nice. Ooh, fancy, fascinating. These are some interesting hollow shaft nut driver set. And they've got a design that allows you to use for different sizes. So it appears it's 12 points. You could use it on 12 point stuff. You could use it on spline stuff, square stuff, or hex stuff. This would be great. Work on a bunch of different stuff. Because we get some wacky projects at Genius Garage. Yes! Drill bits. Oh, thank God. But there's only 1/8 and 1/3/16 in it, which are the two sizes that get broken the most often because those are for the common rivet sizes. But this is spectacularly helpful for all you young people out there looking to do it. A good drill bit set like this, get a quality one. Do not cheap out on drill bits. You want them to be hard. You want them to be good. Take care of them. Don't let your dingbat friends use them because they'll break them. And get them from a company that you can replace when you do break them or resharpen them. Okay, so you get a good set, it's gonna last you a long time. And this is a really good size to give you basically everything you're gonna need unless you're just a serious machinist. So that is spectacularly helpful. Oh my gosh, we've got another box. All right, what do we got here? Ooh, it's heavy. Okay, please be more tools for students and not anthrax or a bomb. I don't think it's gonna be at this point. I'm feeling good. Ooh, all right. Oh, what up? Oh, oh, look out, look out. Woo! Pry bars! Yes! They look good. Okay, cool, they got a metal on the head, up here on the handle, so you can hit it with a hammer, yeah. And you won't wreck your tool. These are very helpful. You would be surprised how often a pry bar is a valuable thing, whether you're working on something heavy, suspension, you just need to push a motor over just a little bit. You know, all those things you don't want to put your hands in and you don't have the strength to do. I think it was it like Archimedes that says, I can move the world if you give me a lever long enough? There you go. Listen to those old people from long, long ago. Okay, what do we got here? More power tools. Oh, yeah. What do we got? Ooh, we got another impact gun. This appears to be it's a 3/8 inch. Oh, it's another 3/8 inch impact gun. All right. So one for the racing and car side and one for the aerospace team. Hooray. What else we got here? 1/2 inch impact. Yes. We've actually got one of these. Might be the same one for Genius Garage. Let's see here. What do I got? What do I got? It's not fuel. This is an older one, older model. Same kind of thing, same company, so you know it's probably pretty good if we actually paid money for it. So this is spectacularly helpful. Let's check it out. Let's open it up. This is fun. So for any of you watching who may end up being a Genius Garage student in the future, here are some tools you will get to use. Ooh, yeah. Look at that. Boom. It's like fishing. If you hold the fish closer to the camera, it looks bigger. Like, so look, that's about a 36 inch largemouth bass. Look at that. I'll be like Bill Dance and kiss it before I throw it away. But you guys probably don't know that because that was in the 80s. Was that Bill Dance that used to kiss bass before he threw them back in the pond? This is spectacular. I guarantee this is going to last forever. I think the students are going to hugely appreciate it too. We got buttons and lights. Hooray. How many Ugga Duggas do you think it's going to take with this? I'm thinking one or two, no three or four. Could probably start an airplane engine with that. All right, got an extra battery, got an extra charger. This is absolutely incredible. I really, honestly, guys, I don't know what to say because the world is not generally nice to anybody or things. So I'm shocked. This is just, I don't know what to say. But thank you to the mystery gentleman. He didn't need a, wasn't an official sponsorship, and he just had some extra tools, and he thought that Genius Garage students could use it, and they sure can. So it means a lot, it's gonna go a long way. So thank you to that mystery gentleman, and I think it's really neat that he didn't even want any credit for it. So, you know, do good things behind the scenes sometimes. But anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed a little stories on tools, and I really just wanted to thank the person that cared enough to donate. Actually, recently, I've noticed a couple of small monetary donations come through for Genius Garage as well from the Petrolicious video, just from car people. So thank you on that. That means a great deal. When I say small, I mean they're big. That is big. I just didn't mean it's like, you know, we're going to go buy a new Formula One car or something. But they're big. They matter. It's obviously being applied directly to getting the students opportunities and learning and what they're doing, and certainly for all these tools. So maybe this is a nice thing on the internet. Wow, what? Oh, and by the way, if you guys ever wonder why people thumbs down my video, there's a couple trolls out there that just do it for fun. I don't know why. So, you know, let's just not do that. This is a nice video. In the meantime, I hope you guys liked it, that you will comment and subscribe. See you next time.